Yes, children, I hope you are done with the table. This is very easy. First one, let me discuss. Separate stones from rice. So why do we separate stones from rice? To remove what? What to remove? To remove the impurities or harmful components, or to remove the non-useful component, to separate two different but useful components. So in the stone and rice, the stone is not a useful thing, right? So to first one will be to remove the non-useful components, right? Second is churning of the meat to obtain butter. So both of the components are useful, so it will be this. Separate the leaves, it will be this. Now to separate, they are asking, what do we do with the separated components? We throw away, right? Stones we throw away, right? The impurities of the tea we throw away, and only for the butter we use both of them. Hey children, so let's move. So children, we see that before we use substances, we need to separate harmful or non-useful substances that may be mixed with it, isn't it? So please underline, before we use a substance, we need to separate harmful or non-useful substances that may be mixed with it, right? Sometimes we separate even useful components if we need to use them separately, right? The substances to be separated may be particles of different sizes or materials. These may be solids, liquids, or even gases. So how do we separate substances mixed together if they have so many different properties? So here we will start the different methods of separation. Okay, children. So we will discuss some simple methods of separating substances that are mixed together. You may come across some of these methods being used in day-to-day activities. So let's start with hand picking. This is the easiest and the first separation method. So what you have to do here, children, this you have to do, okay? This activity you have to perform. Activity number 2, hand picking, okay? So you are picking the non-useful substances or useful substances by hand, okay? So bring a packet of grain purchased from the shop to the classroom. Now spread the grain on the sheet of a paper. Do you find only one kind of grain on the sheet? Yeah, or you find something unwanted substances on the paper? Are there pieces of stones, husk, broken grains, or particles of any other grain in it? Now remove it with the help of your hand and take out the pieces of the stone, husk, and other grains from it. Okay, this is very, very easy. You can help your mother by picking up the stones from the rice, you know, the wherever you feel like there is something. Before, you know, you take out little jeera or little rai, whatever kitchen product available, you can ask to your mother and she'll give you the work to separate by hand picking. So what you have to do is to separate the non-useful substances and throw away, right? Because this is non-useful, right? So this method of hand picking can be used for separating slightly larger size. This is very important, children, okay? Which method is used for what? So this method of hand picking can be used for separating slightly, this is important, larger sized impurities from the piece of dirt, stones, and husk from wheat, okay? So wheat or rice or pulses. The quantity of such impurities is usually not very large. In some situation, we need to find that hand picking is a convenient method of separating substances. Children, you can see here how this man is separating the stones from the wheat. Yeah. So this is the easiest method to separate the non-useful substances from the useful substances, and the quantity of the non-useful substances are not very large, they are small in number. So when the impurities are not very large, then hand picking is possible, right? Moving to next separation method, and that is threshing. Okay, so you must have seen bundles of wheat or paddy stalk lying in the field after harvesting the crops. Okay, stalks are dried in the sun before the grain is separated from them. Okay, when you are harvesting it, the moisture, of course, it remains in the plant, no? So they just cut the stalks and they keep it for sun drying. So you will always find the heap of the stalks kept together, no? The crop. Then when they get dried, each stalk has many grain seeds attached to it. Imagine the number of grain seeds in hundreds of bundles of stalk lying in the field. How does the farmer separate grain seeds from these bundles of stalks? One may pluck mangoes and guavas from the tree, but the grain seeds are much smaller than the guavas and mangoes, isn't it? So plucking them from their stalks would be impossible. How does one separate grain seeds from their stalks? So please underline, children, the process that is used to separate grain from stalk etc. is called threshing. Very important definition, children. Very, very important. The process that is used to separate grains from the stalk is threshing. In this process, the stalks are beaten to free the grain seeds. Okay, they beat it to free the grain seeds. And sometimes threshing is done with the help of bullocks. Machines are also used to thresh large quantity of grain. So here you can see, children, how this man is beating the stalks to free the grain. So here I'm going to show. Okay, children, here you can see how this man is going to beat the stalks and he is freeing the grains. Can you see that? Yeah? So here we'll move to the next video, okay?